Today on Israel Hayom Insider, as Israel prepares to celebrate 68 years of independence, we look at a few things you didn't know about Israel. With me in the studio, Elyssa Frank.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, Elyssa. I'm Steve Ganot. Okay, Elyssa, things you didn't know about Israel. First of all, how do you know when winter or summer are approaching?
Okay, so for me as a photographer, the first sign is the migration of birds.
Oh, interesting.
And there is gazillions of birds that cross from, you probably know this better.
Yeah, it's about a billion birds.
A billion.
Okay, Israel's a land bridge between mm-hmm. continents. Mm-hmm. And so they're coming from Europe, they're coming from Asia, going down to Africa, or going back. And yeah, Israel is a major, major bird migration route.
So at the beach, what we see is that first little kid, he points his finger up, everybody starts looking, and you'll see the formations of the birds. They're phenomenal.
Fantastic.
Yeah, so this is the sign of winter.
Okay, what
Summer.
Else? Give me something.
Okay, you have an old dishwasher that doesn't work or an old washer. What do you do with it?
I throw it outside and hope someone takes it.
Mm-mm. There's this guy and he's just like, Alte Sachen.
Ah, the Alte Sachen guy.
Uh-huh. And I hear clunk, 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 clunk.
Right.
Because he's on it's a horse-driven wagon that he's
right.
bringing around. I mean,
that's
it's
the
pretty
junk
ghetto.
Dealer. The junk dealers go up and down the neighborhoods yelling out, Alte Sachen, Alte Sachen, and you give them your old appliances, old furniture, stuff like that.
I heard Alte Sachen is Yiddish.
It is.
But it's actually Arabs that are the Alte Sachen guy.
That's right.
Okay.
Okay. When are you going to stock up on wine or meat or cheese,
Easy,
things like that?
A holiday time.
That's
so
right.
So, for example, we have like Pesach, mm-hmm. we can have a lot of wine, and so all the wine goes on sale in the supermarkets.
Right, before
Rosh
Pesach
Hashanah.
And before Rosh Hashanah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Shavuot.
Shavuot, what's on sale?
Dairy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and now we're coming to the time of Yom HaTzmaut. We're going to have barbecues, so
right.
all the meat.
Right. And barbecue equipment, the actual barbecues,
oh,
things
right.
like that.
Yeah, it does.
The coals, things like that.
It's
yeah.
true, it does.
Yeah,
I
very
saw
cool.
a cheap one.
It
mm-hmm.
always follows the Hebrew calendar.
Okay, so what animal do you see everywhere in Jerusalem walking around Tel Aviv? I mean, it's where I'm mostly around, but...
Cats.
Cats, it's so weird. It's so strange to me. And we have tons of bats.
That's
33
right.
species. It's crazy.
That's right. Right outside our office here in Tel Aviv, there are some nice, beautiful palm trees full of bats.
Really?
Yeah.
So, and this, you hear them a lot. They have a screechy sound, but not only that, they eat these fruit trees and then they spit the fruit out. I don't really understand why they're here.
Yeah, it's a little disgusting, but they eat a lot of insects.
Insects?
Mm-hmm.
So it's like a natural exterminator?
Absolutely.
Wow, that's cool.
Okay, I'm in line at the supermarket,
uh-huh.
and the guy in front of me, his cart is full of pitot. What's going on? What time of year
oh,
is it?
Oh, it's chametz time. It's Pesach.
It's before Pesach.
All
it's like
the sale
week before
on the...
Pesach.
Right.
Right. So not everyone keeps Pesach. So people who don't have to stock up on bread because it gets emptied from the supermarkets.
Well, you close down, like paper hidden, all the things that are not allowed on Pesach.
That's right.
But we all know, if you want fresh bread on Pesach, where do you go?
You go to Yafo. You go to...
Arab villages.
Arab villages, Arab neighborhoods, absolutely.
Right.
Okay.
So... Let me tell you a little bit about the beaches in Tel Aviv, because that's pretty interesting. There's this one area where you have the religious beach. Yes, we have a religious beach, one day men, one day,
one day
men, one day women, because mm-hmm. they can't see each other. Then we have the dog beach right next to it.
Like a dog-friendly beach?
Yeah, only dogs. Yeah, and dogs are in the water and dogs uh-huh. with the people. That's the only part where the dogs are allowed on the beach.
Okay.
Then we have the gay beach.
Mm-hmm.
And so we actually have these pagodas and they cover them with rainbow colors. And when it comes to the gay parade week and everything, this is like the main area. And then the families.
Mm-hmm.
Now, and this is all in one area.
Mm-hmm.
And this is some of the best surfing beach.
In Tel Aviv.
In Tel Aviv, and it's my area where I swim. So I say that's cool. Some powerful energy of the combination of the group of people.
Okay, Elyssa,
uh-huh.
driving from the top of Israel all the way down to the bottom, how long do you think it takes?
8 hours?
Less than that. It's less than six, actually.
Really?
It used to be like eight, but now it's become faster.
Oh, is that why? Wow, okay. So
yeah.
you go from a snowy mountain to like tropical paradise in Eilat.
Right. That's right.
And in the middle is the lowest point on Earth, which
that's
is
right.
the Dead Sea.
That's right.
Wow, that's wild. Okay, so I get to Israel. I'm an Ashkenazi Jew. Obviously, they're going to have the best bagels here. They are going to have the best chicken soup on takeout, right?
Not
in the hospitals, we're going to get the best chicken soup.
Nope.
No?
No, you might, what you might think is like, oh, Israel, bagels, Israel, delis.
Mm-mm. Yeah, deli sandwiches, right?
Nope. It's very hard to find a good deli sandwich in Israel. Very hard to find a good bagel.
Really?
But there's more and more of them.
Hmm.
Okay, coexistence, you know, coexistence between Jews and Arabs. Oh, there's a lot more of it than you think. A lot more than people know about.
It's not uncommon for a doctor or nurse to be treating somebody with post-traumatic stress disorder or PTSD, and that doctor or that nurse is an Arab.
That's right.
I mean, that's amazing coexistence.
That's right. We have a long way to go in some ways, but the coexistence here, I mean, people just don't understand that on an everyday basis, you go to the doctor, you might be Arab, might be Jewish.
Yeah.
You know, that's true everywhere, all across the country.
Yeah, I just think it's more about compassion and people are just wanting other people to feel better or good, and they don't really, it's not about faith or religion or anything like that. So it's a great sign of coexistence that we have here.
Yep. Okay, fruits and vegetables, they are seasonal.
Absolutely.
So, you know, you'll go to the supermarket looking for an avocado and you won't find one because they're just not in season.
But not only that, in Israel, it's a very well-known fact that a strawberry actually tastes like a strawberry.
Yeah.
A tomato actually tastes like a tomato.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Like, I grew up, strawberries did not taste like this. Tomatoes did not taste like this. And I think we talked a little bit about the eggs, which you didn't really understand, which is the yolks here are almost yellow-orange.
Yeah, they're kind of
orangey. And in America, they're like totally yellow.
Yeah,
and
I guess I don't cook enough to know the difference, but yeah.
Well, neither do I, but they're fresher. It's I think it has something to do with kibbutz or dairy, because even the milk is better tasting here.
Mm, yeah.
Did you tell me something about the cows?
Oh, Israel has like record-breaking cows. I mean, the milk yield of Israel's cows breaks all the records in the world.
That is the weirdest fact ever.
Yeah. So to all of our viewers, have a great, happy Independence Day. We'll be out barbecuing. We'll be out celebrating. You guys do the same thing. And we will see you next time.
Chag Sameach.